Don't write GVP, write guarded visual prognosis, because GVP can also stand for good visual prognosis.
Yeah.
So I'll go to my talk now. Can you connect this? Yeah. Yeah. So the talk is the tackling the lens post open globe injuries. Karan Ghatia. So cut short. See, lens injury is the most common form of injury that's associated post open globe traumas, and actually the outcome is generally much poorer due to the associated injuries rather than the trauma itself. So a preoperative assessment is extremely important, because it's and helps in planning and what you're supposed to do, the size of the tear, what is the location, whether any lens is involved or not, what is the status of the vitreous, whether it is prolapsed or not, whenever there's an AC depth or even a sign of that indicates basically site subluxation. You can also go to retroillumination and look for that the edge, lens edge, in case of subluxation. The role of radiology has already been explained in the previous talks. So there's always a disparity between the preoperative findings and the intraoperative findings. So when you're going in, if you suspect there is vitreous, always inject triamcinolone and confirm. So the first step every time in any such cases, subluxated lenses, trauma, is to actually do a vitrectomy first and then proceed to the normal handling the lens. So this basically is according to the hair database. As you can see, generally the anterior, if you see preoperatively, it is also involved intraoperatively. But posteriorly, sometimes you suspect that the posterior capsule is intact. However, you might land up in a surprise that there is some sort of a trauma and is actually damaged there itself. So it can be an anterior or posterior breach. You can have an intraocular foreign body. So be prepared for any intraoperative surprises. No treatment is generally necessary for the breach of the lens itself. So so this is a video that I'll show. Is it working there? Yeah. So this is a small tear with a cataractous lens over here. So in such cases, what you can do is you can suture up the, you can put the iris into position, then suture the corneal tear. And in such cases, you can convert these sort of breaches in the lens capsule. And then you can actually do an aspiration of the lens matter and then put an IOL in that. So I'll just brief through this video fast. However, sometimes what happens is you're always in for a surprise. So this is a simple case. I'm moving forward without any problem, but look, there was something happened. So we'll go through a little bit in slow motion. You can see that there's actually a PC tear that had happened over here. Now this could be a pre-existing one, or did it happen with because of my carelessness. That's different, but then in such cases, always tampon out the vitreous, do an automated anterior vitrectomy, always try to do automated, and that's the dictum nowadays, and then you can always put a multifocal IOL in the sulcus or in the back. So this is a very good video that I found on YouTube by Dr. Deepak Megho. He makes fantastic videos. And in such cases, what is shown over here is there's a corneal tear with an intraocular foreign body, and there is a lens perforation as well. So in such cases, this is from his video only that I'm showing, that the planning on the incision is very important. Now the incision should be opposite to the area of the tear or the foreign body. So in such a case, rather than a temporal one, I would go for a 12 o'clock position, because the large foreign body can come through that area out. So this is his video. So what he's done first is that he's injected OVD inside, made a scleral tunnel, and then he has gone in and then taken out the intraocular foreign body, and see how large it is. And then what he's done is he's sutured the tear, and followed by what he's done some aspiration of the lens, and then when he's got this edge of the anterior capsule, he's converted into some sort of a rexus, enlarged it a bit, and then he's put a multifocal IOL in the sulcus. So what happens is lens fragmentation is actually the major cause of inflammation in such cases. It causes a raise in IOP, and all particles have to be removed if they are in the anterior chamber. Because this is lens particles plus vitreous plus blood is actually a potential inciter for PVR development. So cataract is the most common form of injury. It is the main cause of visual disturbance apart from the astigmatism that is caused post-tear. So the progression can take place from minor to total in a couple of hours to years, and basically it's generally soft. For such cases, aspiration itself will do the job. So intervention should be influenced by the presence or the potential of the posterior segment pathology. So I'll just show a tear over here, one more tear. So what has happened over here is this is a secondary tear, the secondary IOL that is being implanted over here, the secondary cataract surgery after the primary tear was done. So it, see, these adhesions are very hard. So sometimes you have to go with a Varner scissor and you have to cut it out. So after the aspiration part, sometimes what you see over here is these plaques are there. So these plaques are the ones you have to go underneath it. You have to inject sometimes OVD underneath, and after injecting that OVD, you have to sometimes get that plane and then you can cut with the Varner, and basically then you can peel it off like a rexus. And once that is done, you get a good player, you get a good central area. After that, the synechia can be released. You can also use hooks in the middle while if there's any problem with the visualization of the pupil is small, followed by the implantation of a multifocal of a three-piece lens. So I won't go to this video. You can deal with subluxation cases. So imagine the goal over here, the most important point is to avoid iatrogenic damage to the retina. It is sometimes you have to sacrifice the lens, sacrifice it. The important point over here is not the IOL implantation, but it is a good wound integrity, no inflammation, no PVR changes, nothing. The retina has to be prevented. So preserving the capsule sometimes further increases the risk of anterior PVR and thysis also. So coming to the IOL implant, the primary and the secondary cataract extraction, primary is generally a single surgery and helps the prevention of secondary complications, mainly glaucoma, and gives immediate visual rehabilitation. However, what happens is after that post-operatively, you can have the advantage of that is you can put the IOL first in and later on it can be a problem. Secondary cases, what happens is that you can find the advantages that you give an optimal IOL power and you can manage astigmatism and you can put toric IOLs also and you can do it a better job. So coming to that, the timing is actually controversial and multiple people recommend different things, but primary you would generally do in a child and a poor patient or a compliant patient who's not good, a poorly compliant patient who wouldn't come for a follow-up. Secondary is generally recommended because of lens inflammation and you can tackle the astigmatism as well. Coming to the biometry, sometimes what happens is you don't know the K readings of that. So you can take the A scan of the concerned eye and you can use the keratometry readings of the other eye and use that and then get the power. So single piece to multi piece depends. If the capsule bag is good, you can put a single piece IOL in the bag. If not, you can always put a multi piece IOL as well. Post-operatively control the inflammation, evaluate the fundus, that's very important, and suture management is always there. Yes, sir. I have one more after this.
Let me finish and can
Sure, sir. Huh? Yeah, I'll just summarize. Yeah. So a small tear with cataract can be taken up for primary combined surgery. The lens fragments in the AC have to be removed. The anterior capsular tear management is controversial. Secondary IOL is recommended. And the goal is mainly to prevent the iatrogenic damage to the retina. Thank you so much.
Okay.